cards for Arsenal as the newly crowned Premier League champions lined up against Newcastle United in the 1990 FA Cup final. The two clubs had met each other in both the 1932 and 1952 finals, with Newcastle coming out on top in both. Newcastle manager Kenny Dalglish was looking to win the competition for a third time, whilst on the Arsenal bench, Frenchman Arsene Wenger was experiencing an FA Cup final for the very first time. The commentary comes from Ron Atkinson and Brian Moore.
Well, here's the Arsenal side without Dennis Bergkamp, of course, but Christopher Wray, who replaces him.
Ian Wright on the subs bench, but Marc Overmars is here, the midfield of Manu Petit, Patrick Vieira and Ray Parlour, and behind them that defence that really is second to none. Newcastle had hoped that Keith Gillespie would be fit to cause trouble down the wing, but he's not, and that's a blow. Kenny Dalglish has shaken up the defence a little. Steve Howie comes back. Philip Albert is a sub. It looks as though they'll play 4-4-2. And up front, Timur Kitzbayer of Georgia partners Alan Shearer.
So the cup final is underway. Newcastle in those famous stripes. And a touch straight away for the boy from Donegal, Shea Given. Arsenal on an afternoon of brilliant sunshine, where they're looking for the double, just as they did in similar conditions, incidentally, in 1971. Stuart Pearce playing it forward to Kitzbayer. Speed is coming in there, and speed can be a danger. He does make those drifting runs in from the left, gets good positions. His finishing hasn't always been of the best, but who knows, today might be the day. Good jump there from Davizas.
Brian, I actually think that's the key area midfield.
Yes. Keown getting it back. And interesting with Kitzbayer up front, because he'll run at people as well. Kitzbayer. And Rob Lee caught offside.
That's where Rob Lee's at his best, you know. I mean, I think there's been times this year when Rob Lee's played a very sort of safe sitting position. I always thought when they were really flying Newcastle, Lee was making an awful lot of breaks from midfield. I think that's encouraging if he's prepared to run off the back of Petrie.
Keown, hit long, dealt with quite comfortably by Howie. Stuart Pearce. Play by Vieira. Winterburn, what a season he's had. That's not the best pass of the season, though. Oh, Pearce with a cut eye. Mind you, anybody who knows Stuart Pearce will know that that is the last thing that will
stop
him.
Doing that shaving this morning.
I think, naturally he was very disappointed at being left out of Glenn's 30 for the World Cup, but he didn't show it. He's taken it very well. But equally, you can be sure there, on the back of that, there'll be no more determined man on the field today than Stuart Pearce. Hit long again.
Carlos going away. This is a good break. Anelka's waiting in the middle. And in the end, Howie had to get across there at the expense of the corner. Great ball, though, and a great run by Parler.
Very, very ominous at the beginning. You know how much more pace they appear to have in attacking positions, Arsenal, and maybe the counterparts defensively for Newcastle.
Keown forwards. Vieira, six-footer forward. And, in fact, Derek Wright coming on to have a look at Stuart Pearce's eye.
I'm surprised in the early period just how much infield Warren Barton's done when plays on the other side. I would have thought he'd been detailed to say, hey, you stay around the Overmars. When they've got it, when Arsenal have it at the back, get in front of him so they can't play into feet and allow Pistone to have a little bit of a head start on him. If he gets drawn in field, they'll pop the ball off to Overmars all day.
Still getting some treatment. The referee's not entirely happy.
Swinging one, and tipped away well by Shea Given. I think he's given the foul, Brian.
Adams riding on the back of somebody there, but that's a typical Arsenal corner. They all have a little flurry, and Adams spins right round the back. You know, and they'll have done the homework, they'll know about that, but still a little bit disturbing, yep, the fact he got in there.
Speed again, winning it in the air. Here's Ketsbier. Here's Ketsbier again. He might get into a shooting position here.
It surprises you, he never seems to be a regular favourite, does he, Ketsbier? He never really seems to make the starting lineup.
I think there's some good attacking players here. We shall pick up a goal or two, don't worry. Vieira floating it through. Pistone with a header back, and not a very good one. And at that, he couldn't quite hold on to it, given. It's provided Arsenal with another corner.
We've seen Petit make breaks from the middle of the field. Once when he pressurised Lee, in that particular instance, when, you know, they've given him the... Pistone's given an unnecessary corner away.
Omar's again. Deep one, and flicked on by... I think it's probably Anelka who flicked it on.
Buzz Bryant. Yeah, once again, a little bit disturbing if you're in the Newcastle camp. He's flipped it up. This time, Adams has made it.
Vieira. Adams. Vieira. Oh, beautiful play. Eluded those two challenges superbly. Parler picks up Dixon.
Looks for the return. Ray Parler. Harris trying to keep it in. And just over the top from Anelka. And it was a wonderful chance for Arsenal.
That was a great break. And the architect of it was Vieira in the first place.
There's some super football.
Petit to Tony Adams. Petit knocking it forward.
Overmars, has he got in behind Pistone? Overmars! 1-0!
This is a lovely through ball. It's been threatening, but terrible marking from Pistone. He's marking on the outside. They've allowed a lot of space behind for a player who's one of the quickest in the world. And to be fair, all right, it has a little bit of touch of luck when he just makes the keeper shake given. But that's great play on the Arsenal's point of view. Terrible defending there. Ball watching, wrong position. I mean, you know a man like Overmars is a threat. Wherever the ball is, you mark him. But they've been threatening to do that all match, Brian.
With Shearer, you've always got a chance. Yeah. Here's Pistone. Shearer chasing this, but Adams... Well, for once, Adams didn't complete the job, and Shearer bangs it in again. It comes for Ketsbier. It comes for Ketsbier. It's a shot that stings the hands of David Seaman, but no more than that. But there was the warning, and there's the suggestion that Newcastle aren't by any means out of this cup final.
I must admit, it's a big, deep cross, skims off his head, takes it in one.
Getting out to Ketsbier. Speed. Knocked off the ball there. Won't come through to Shearer either. And a squad of red shirts come flying forward again. And look at the pace of Anelka again. That's incredible pace by Nicholas Anelka. And that was total optimism.
Well, you said about that, Bryce. Look at this. He makes up the ground here. It's like there's a treading water and going backwards at the moment. As you say, a little bit more composure, but 4 marks, thank you. What is he, 19? But I know one famous commentator that always used to say it only takes a second.
That's right.
And there's only one goal to diff at the moment.
That's right. Barton. In goes Winterburn. Pierce. Shearer. That's a free kick. That's a free kick. The foul by Keown. And it's, I guess, 8 to 10 yards outside the Arsenal penalty area.
I don't know whether it's Stuart Pearce territory or not. It might
Shearer,
well be.
I think, right.
Or Shearer.
It's a right-footed ball, I would guess. Although you never know with Pearce, he can blatter them from anywhere, couldn't he?
Well, it looks as though he wants to say. Kitzmeyer's there too.
I think it'll be Shearer.
Yeah, I think it will.
Maybe, well, I don't know. It depends how much room Seaman leaves on his right hand. But he has Scudin score his first goal for Newcastle from here.
Well, it's either Shearer or Pearce. Well, it's going to be something like 28 yards. It's Shearer. Too high. I guess he's a bit frustrated at the moment too, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, that's you don't blame him for having a go at that. He wants to get it up and down quickly, but he hasn't had any sort of a chance. He hasn't had a crumb to feed off, and that's, you know, that's something you'd be looking for.
Here's Barton. As we come towards half-time, Newcastle looking for a decisive break that brings them back into this game. Pistone, Lee, a bit of space ahead of him. Speed has come to this side as well. Pistone, that cross is far too close while it's behind the goal in any case.
Last few minutes, a few more signs that Newcastle have sort of, whether Arsenal have put an awful lot in it and just stepping off the gas a little bit, and Newcastle are coming and having their time, but they've just started to get into the game a little bit.
Without any great conviction, to be honest.
No, I mean, Seaman, apart from the Kitzmeyer shots, has had a comparatively easy match. Well, he's had ever such an easy match.
Harris header, looking it towards Pearce, that left him a little bit stranded. And Parler playing it in now for Ray. And Ray with a shot was too high.
The only criticism of Arsenal at all today. I mean, I think they've been excellent in the first half, but maybe they frittered one or two little things. I mean, good control. Probably in keeping with the rest of the game, that should have been on target.
Good play here by Lee. Oh, and he's... Well, he found Warren Barton, but Barton slipped at the crucial moment, and here comes Vieira. And here come Arsenal again. Ray blocked well, though. And here's Pistone, who'll keep it going for Newcastle now. Barton, though, challenged by Ray, beaten by him. Petit, and away goes Overmars again. Demizas is trying to get across him. And Anelka's in the middle. Ray Parler wants it as well, and it's over the top.
Another glaring example. They just had a let-off just before this. That Davidas had won a challenge on Ray, which could have put Overmars through. As Overmars runs, sets the ball up. That's not an easy shot to hit, but the way they're playing Arsenal, that should have made the keeper work.
It's Adams being chased by Shearer, and Shearer putting Adams to the ground. And the referee has put his hand in his pocket, and Shearer is going to get a yellow card. Yellow card for Shearer. What about that, Ron?
I think it's a bit of afters from the others. I think that's a genuine competition. We have to accept, I mean, without going into the things that Leicester do, we have to accept that Shearer will chase lost causes. And sometimes, if you're a little bit short on it, you're gonna make contact with people. I don't deliberately think that he went to do in there.
But I think also it was conditioned by what had gone before. You
asked? Yeah, I think so. It's a little bit of afters.
Well, there's the half-time. It's not been a bad first half for Arsenal. They played well. Mark Overmars' goal after 23 minutes is what divides the sides. And it was Petit playing it in here. And it was a lovely ball. And Pistone just couldn't get to grips with Overmars. So here comes the second half. Kitzmeyer. Still away on this left flank with Shearer very much the lone man up front, looking for support from the Kitzmeyers and the Speeds, Rob Lees and so on of this world. Pistone, a deflection into the path of Robert Lee. Batty's gone forward for him. He hasn't changed the personnel. I'll ask Ron in a moment if he thinks he's changed the shape of the side. Here's Pistone well forward, looking for a good cross, and the young Italian failing dismally to provide it. I think David Platt might be coming on. Now,
Shearer played in Debatty. This looks better again for Newcastle. Lee. Good break by Lee. Batty couldn't pick it up. But Newcastle get a free kick.
How times have changed in this day. Years ago, Stuart Pearce would have been there already in this position.
Well, he's getting across there now.
But they're very untidy at the moment, Arsenal. Complete contrast to the first half when they were composed and strong and professional.
Well, Stuart Pearce
has also moved that ball for about 5 yards as well. It'll be a penalty before he takes it.
Paul Durkin was too quick for that. But we've seen him over the years. He's hit some stormers from this sort of range. Stuart Pearce against the Arsenal wall, against David Seaman, to bring this back to level terms. But he hits it into the wall, and Arsenal maybe have a chance to break. No, good play there by Lee. And that's another free kick. The foul on Davitas by Tony Adams.
Well, I can't have too many complaints about that. Davitas has done him for pace. All of a sudden, you could get a right dramatic swing round, couldn't you?
Well, we've been saying for most of the second half that there is a new look about Newcastle United in their attitude. So the free kick floated in. And, wow! And it was Davitas who won the free kick in the first place, who was so close. He scored once with a header for Newcastle since he arrived from Olympiacos, and just off the top of the crossbar.
Yeah, I mean, it's a dangerous ball from Lee. As you say, out climbs the crowd scene and hits the top of the bar.
And we hear from Gary Newbon on the bench that Kenny Dalglish has just told Ketspire to get well forward and play right alongside to Alan Shearer. And Shearer's on his own. Shearer now. Oh, against the post. Newcastle are having no luck at all. That's Davitas against the post with a header. And now Shearer against the post with a terrific shot. A chance that came out of nowhere. And Newcastle were within, well, a lick of paint of being level.
Well, it came basically because Keown was sloppy, dwelt on the ball, stumbled on it against one of the best strikers in the world. But I must admit, when he shaped up, I didn't really fancy Shearer from there on his left side. That was a superb strike.
And now back for Arsenal.
And there used to be a saying years ago, lucky Arsenal, and that's something you'd subscribe to in the last few minutes.
Overmars on the far side. And Shearer gave us an example of his true world-class worth there.
Yeah.
Look at the chance out of nothing. His strength,
desire, accuracy, Seaman nowhere.
Vieira, still only a goal in it. Parla, and now Anelka off. Oh, no, the flag stays down. It's Anelka. It's a goal! 2-0.
Brian.
That settles it. That settles it.
I wonder here, Brian. I wonder. Oh. You almost called it. This will be an interesting playback, this. You almost called it in commentary whether he was offside, wouldn't you?
Well, there was a degree of suspicion about the offside, but the linesman kept the flag down, and Nicholas Anelka made absolutely sure.
Great finish. Terrific finish. I thought he should have gone on, but he hit it across the keeper brilliantly. But I'd love to see this from the side. My first reaction was he was offside, and I'm still not convinced he wasn't. But that's a super finish.
Here's Batty. Bit of space for Rob Lee. Couldn't make most of it. Adams was there. Rob Lee is still battling, though. But Arsenal get it away to Parla. And now to Platt, who's got fresh legs. And now to Anelka, who's got the swiftest of legs. And he takes on Pistone. And he's got past Pistone. The ball over the top.
There can be a disadvantage of being as quick as Anelka, you know. He runs so far away, the lads have to burst blood vessels to catch up with him. Look at that, there's an overdrive, a bit of turbo there. Shrugs the Italian boy off, nice little turn inside, sets once again, should have been on target.
Here's Pistone. Banged away. Can Shearer do something here? No. Because Winterburn had got back there when Shearer had pulled his finger on the trigger.
But somehow the shot didn't fire out because Winterburn had got there first and it went behind for the corner. Vieira into Platt. And Elk is chasing. Here's Parler. Dixon. Here's Parler. Oh, he's done well here, but oh, he's done well here, Parler. Oh! Well, Pistone claims that he was having his shirt tugged, but Parler made an irresistible run through there and just into the side netting. Here's Anderson. He's got a bit of pace about him. He's got a finish to him, has he? Oh! Just was fractioned wide from Gary Speed.
They must be asking themselves why. You know, I know the game changes from the situation 1-0 down, but they've certainly, if they'd have maybe driven the game like this in the first half, they may not have been looking down the barrel at half-time.
Correct, correct. Plays it up once more to Lee. A chip forward now, again to the willing Shearer. Speed. Still with Speed. Still looking for Shearer, but that time Keown got there.
Arsenal have completed the double. Only the second club ever, Manchester United were the first, to do a double-double. First in 1971 and now in 1998. Mark Overmars started it with that goal after 23 minutes. And Nicolas Anelka sealed it for good and all with that thundering goal in the second half. Newcastle, well, they didn't do themselves justice in the first half, but they battled out superbly in the second, hit the woodwork twice, had chances, and on another day might well have made two or three goals themselves. But it's Arsenal who go into the record books, and for once it's Kenny Dalglish who couldn't find a way to find a winning side here at Wembley. Returns to North London with Arsenal's Tony Adams. The seventh time they've won it, and applause for Arsenal, let it be reported, from all the Newcastle fans here. There's a great picture of all the Newcastle fans who are applauding Arsenal almost as much as their own fans. And really, it's been that sort of occasion on the day.